Hi, welcome to this week's episode of The Shtick. We're here in the studio with a couple of odd characters, and they're going to tell us something about their theatrical experience. And we have with us Raoul Salter and Stephen Curtis.
Hello.
You are two of the original Saltpillar Theatre crew.
Well, I like to think of myself as original.
Yeah, they are. And we want to know just a little bit about Saltpillar. Yeah. See, I always get that wrong.
That's what
Salt Theatre.
Yeah, it's 30 years this year. It's hard to believe.
We weren't there at the beginning.
We were. We haven't changed, though. That's the good thing. It came out of the Orgeous Comedy Review.
Really?
Yeah, that was Ernie Schwartz's idea. It was hit the set, and we did that. We ran that for a couple of years, and then we thought this should be permanent, it sort of morphed out of that.
Well, I think it's important to probably mention that the reason it actually came to be was it was fairly mercenary. You know, a lot of people wanted to perform, and the only way to perform is to really create your own theatre company. Mm. Then you're guaranteed you can perform.
Yeah. It came out of Orgeous Comedy Review, and that was in 1986. And Ernie Schwartz got that going. And after 2 years, we decided that, it was again Ernie's seed of his idea, was that this should be a permanent structure. And it was born out of that, basically. And it's been a permanent community project for the last 30 years.
Have you both performed in the place as well?
Yes. And very well, we might add.
Yeah. To rave reviews, no doubt.
Well,
yeah.
Yes.
But,
certainly to reviews. We have.
Yeah, look, it's we love performing, but we also love the thrill of creating the production and filling the house. So it's been great.
And this year's show is going to be a hilarious comedy, apparently.
It's not just a comedy, it's a world premiere.
It is, yep. It's been written by Rob Selzer, who's a local playwright.
We must mention he's a psychiatrist.
He's a shrink. Yeah.
He's still a shrink, but he's not clinical, he's not seeing patients.
Therefore he'd be known to most members of the Jewish community.
That's true. He doesn't see patients, he just sees actors these days, and it's about the same thing. But
Really?
I don't know. He's telling a story.
I've known Rob for a long time, and we spoke in December. When was it? December 2016. Anyway, and I said, look, you know, Saltpillar, and he was already starting with his writing, and he said, look, I'll write you a comedy. So that was very exciting for us. Our biggest challenge is getting really good new material. It's very hard to find. So to have someone write something for you was a great opportunity.
And the one thing we know about our audiences that have been fantastic and very loyal over the years is the one thing that they really yearn really is comedy. They love it. I mean, we've put on numerous shows over the years and even tried our hand at a musical many years ago, which went down very well critically.
Falsettos.
Which was part of a trilogy.
Went down very well, went up very well.
Went up very well, that's right. Mm. And but comedy seems to be, at the end of the day, that's our bread and butter.
Mm. So the show's called In Bed With the Bishops.
Mm, yes. So Rob Selzer, he's called on his, I think, his clinical past a little bit with this one. Mm. It covers couples and relationship therapy, but with a humorous bent and a little bit of a twist. And it's a funny script. He's done a really good job with it, we think. So.
And it's starring Tiffany Davis.
Yes,
as the wife.
She's the wife. She's superb, isn't she? She does a great job.
And Adi Snir.
Yep, Adi's the
husband.
Slightly henpecked husband.
And slightly.
Yeah, that's right.
And we have the fellow who plays the psychiatrist.
Yeah, Joseph. He's doing a very good job. He's got it's a very big
Don't
part.
Forget the last name, Joseph Sherman.
Joseph Sherman.
Sherman.
That's right. And, of course,
Tali Brash.
She does a beautiful Zelda, the old mentor. She's wonderful in that.
Quite accomplished in her own right.
Mm. Yeah, she has many personalities, but she's
That's
used
right.
one of her many personalities
exactly.
to really bring it out in this play.
Yeah, that's right.
Which is great. It's going to be on at the Phoenix Theatre.
Phoenix Theatre. It's kind of our home, isn't it? We've done almost all of our shows there, with a few small exceptions. But, yeah, from August the 11th to the 26th, We've got 12 performances, so something for everyone in there.
Including a couple of matinees.
Yeah, a couple of matinees. For
and three Q&As.
Q&As.
On the 12th, 14th and 16th.
That's right. That's excellent. Well done.
So two matinees and three Q&As.
So Rob Seltzer is going to stay behind on those nights, whoever wants to stick around and
analyse him.
Yeah, absolutely.
He can be analysed for once.
So both those people that remain in the audience can ask another question.
Yes.
No, I'm sure you'll have capacity crowds. I've been to quite a few of your shows, and I have done a feature on one of your shows many years ago. I thought it's about time, especially since it's your 30th anniversary, to bring you guys on and talk about the show. Unfortunately, Channel 31 has got us on a roster where we're 4 weeks ahead of ourselves. So by the time this comes to Channel 31, the show will be well and truly over.
Let's talk about how it went.
How did it go? Tell me.
We had packed houses.
Right. So in retrospect, we have to say that what we want to do is encourage our viewers who are watching it right now on YouTube, because we go to YouTube immediately.
Yep.
So on the 1st of August, it'll be up on YouTube well before the show starts, but it won't be on Channel 31, which is a bit of a problem we're having with that bit.
Channel 31.
But that's not your problem.
No.
It's ours. It's just an issue. It's not a problem.
No. We can talk about next year's show, which is very excited about that one too.
Another world premiere.
World premiere. By two Melbourne women have written this show, Michelle Schwartz
and Angie Fox.
Yeah, next August.
Angie Fox.
Yes, August 2019.
Sorry, the name of the show, I interrupted you.
Yeah, what's it called?
Solomon's Secrets.
Well, that sounds really exciting for next year.
Yeah.
And maybe if the shtick is still going next year, we'll have you on again and maybe we'll have a bit more time to promote it for
you. Even if it's not going, Henry, we'd love to sit and chat with you.
We don't need these cameras. We don't need the lights.
Perish the thought.
It's been really great to have you both on.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming along. And anybody, this is for the YouTube viewers, if you want to subscribe to the Shtick TV, we're on YouTube, which is where you'll be seeing these fellows well in advance of the show. And then after that, if you're watching it on Channel 31, you missed out and you have to wait till next year. Maybe we'll have a rerun of The Bishops in Bed.
In Bed with the Bishops.
Yeah, we'll have that again, maybe that good.
We could.
By popular demand.
Yeah, that's right.
And tickets are still available too on YouTube. I mean, by to the YouTube people.
And you've got a website.
Saltpillar.org.au.
That's what we want.
Yep.
And we'll be back after the break with Noah Block, who's a very interesting young lady. We'll see her on the shtick in the next segment.